The views and opinions expressed on this program are not necessarily those of this station, JVC Broadcasting Management, or its sponsors.
Hi, I'm Karen Signoracci. For over 20 years, I've devoted my career to helping nonprofits reach their goals, increase their funding, broaden their donor base, and their community outreach. In addition, I've worked with my nonprofit clients to get the right people around the table to serve and execute the mission of the organization for its betterment and its service to the community. If you're considering starting a nonprofit, serve on a nonprofit board of directors, or are currently struggling to get your organization to the next level, please visit KarenSCS.com. That's KarenSCS.com. Let me know how I can help you increase your efficiency. One of the key components to a successful nonprofit are its board of directors. They are integral to the success by setting strategy, vision, and taking on fiduciary responsibility. Making key decisions is also part of this role. Please visit KarenSCS.com. That's KarenSCS.com. And let's speak about making your nonprofit and your vision. Hello, hello, and welcome. This is The Big Picture on 103.9 Long Island News Radio. I am your host, Karen Signoracci. I have spent the last 20 years working with various nonprofits, building nonprofit boards, community outreach, and raising money. All great things. And there's so much good work being done on Long Island. There are so many nonprofits that are contributing to our society. And we are going to talk about a bunch of different things today. I have Nina McCann here. Hello, Nina.
Hi, Karen.
Now, I know Nina from networking and a bunch of different things, which we're going to get into. But she's going to talk to us a little about her career and what she does. And we're also going to talk about the Social Media Association of Long Island. Right, Nina?
Yes.
That's our plan.
That's our plan.
And, you know, we start the big picture and we talk about food, Nina. That's how it goes.
Mm-hmm.
So you have to tell us, is there anywhere you've eaten recently or anything you've made that you want to share and tell us about?
Eaten recently. Well, I just came back from a nice vacation in Aruba and had a lot of great seafood while I was there. So I tend to favor those types of restaurants.
Any particular seafood? Anything that was just noteworthy? We're not just talking shrimp and like crab cakes, a little bit.
No, I like obviously lobster and like octopus and stuff like that. And I go to Jordan's Lobster, you know, in the summer. It's a staple.
It's a great spot.
Mm-hmm.
Sit outside.
Mm-hmm.
Great spot. Yes.
Mm-hmm. So that's one of my go-tos. And then, you know, out east in Riverhead, there's another, I can't think of the name at the moment, but there's a lot of like just fresh, you know, lobster roll places out there and just places to get lobster in the summer. It's another summer staple to do. You know,
that's great. Listen, we always talk about food here to kick it off and no one's brought up lobster yet. So
okay.
You're the first. So that's a good thing. I like it.
Maybe I'm still in summer vibe mode.
Maybe. And that's okay. That's fine. That's a positive. We all know how we love the beach here. We
mm-hmm.
have some great beaches.
Yes.
And I know also that you have a background. We're going to talk about you now for a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
You have a background in marketing.
Mm-hmm.
You have a background. I know you're networking and you have a lot of connections. Just give us a little bit about, you know, your personal journey, your career path, and how the Social Media Association weaved in and how nonprofits have weaved in for you.
Absolutely. Well, I am a marketing and business development professional. I've been doing it for about 20 years. My space is the professional services environment, so that's law firms and accounting firms and financial services firms. I've worked at all three. For the most part, my career has been law firm based. And for 10 years, for more than 10 years, it was a very Long Island focused law firm. So it exposed me to a lot of the local nonprofits here. And in my role, you know, not only, you know, doing the day-to-day marketing and public relations and advertising, you know, I would go out and I would be able to network, as you said, and meet the nonprofits and community-based organizations that we worked with and got to know them, got to know their missions, how they worked. And, you know, I know a lot of them.
You do know a lot of them. You know, in regard to networking and being out there and charity events and nonprofits, Is there anyone in particular that stands out that's unique or different that you would say, I go to this event every year, it's one of my, anything that just jumps out at you?
Well, there's so many, and for so many different reasons. There's obviously the great causes that you just want to support annually, but there's also, Long Island does a great job with bringing together different organizations in one big area. For example, there's like the hospitality ball.
Okay.
That's a great one, you know, that has a lot of different vendors in the hospitality industry, the food, the restaurants, the spirits. There's also Fight for Charity. I believe we attended that many a time.
Many times, yes.
That is very that's a very unique fundraising event that, again, raises lots of funds for amazing, you know, charities. With the boxing component that you're taking it for the team, you're going in the ring and boxing, but it's a fun time and you're raising money for charities.
Well, the interesting thing about Fight for Charity, having attended that in the past and having some friends and colleagues that have fought, is there's a food component too.
Yes, there is.
Well, the restaurants there, yep, that are generously donating their time on a Monday evening, mm-hmm, and their staff and food to be there, mm-hmm, so people can eat and sample all these different foods. And then you're right, there's a boxing match and all the money that they raise goes to various different charities that those boxers select. Yeah, that's a great example. It's very different. Mm-hmm. You know, one other thing before we get into the Social Media Association of Long Island, in your work with the marketing firms and outreach, if you flip the other side, mm-hmm, and we talk about nonprofits and them looking to receive sponsorships, is there anything that stands out from the giving money perspective as opposed to the general fundraising, you know, something that firms or companies would want to see when they're looking to support someone?
I find that we like to see when our brand or, mm-hmm, our logo is associated with our charity. You know, it's important to us to, you know, showcase, well, we do support them, and, you know, and be listed as that, be known as that. You know, obviously there's a connection there by, you know, the head of the company or certain groups within the company, and they're proud of it. So they want to, you know, their logo there or their name, you know, on a wall of honor or something.
So seeing their name as part of an event, as, mm-hmm, part of the, mm-hmm, support and the logo and,
yes,
and just that recognition.
Absolutely. The recognition and the connection. It connects.
It connects. Mm-hmm. It connects. Okay, so let's now talk about the Social Media Association of Long Island. Maybe give us a little bit of the background and how you got involved. And it is not just you. There's a nice array of people that are part of this organization, so it's vast.
Yes, that is correct. So I am a board member of the Social Media Association of Long Island. It's a trade association focused on social media and digital communications for business. We put on programs to network. We put on educational programs. We have a website, socialmediaassociation.com, where you can, there's a job bank there. And, you know, our goal is really to promote social media in all types of businesses, you know, for-profit, non-profit. Every industry needs to be, have social media channels and push their information out. But we consider ourselves just a premier resource for companies. We're setting the standard, you know, through our programs. We have great, you know, hot topic type programs. We just recently had one on ChatGPT and AI. And we also have programs that kind of like roundtable programs. We have one coming up soon where it's like an open forum. So if there's issues that we're not aware of or just topics where, you know, our community is interested in, you know, we'll have an open forum and we'll discuss it. And, you know, if need be, we'll create a program around it and get you know, somebody, a thought leader in it to speak further. So we're always trying to even learn as a board member and, you know, teach our community.
So you're a board member of, mm-hmm, the Social Media Association of Long Island. It's an all-volunteer,
yes,
organization.
Yes.
And the members of the organization may work for a corporate entity. They might work for nonprofits. Mm-hmm. They might be sole practitioners themselves.
Yes.
Supporting various types of organizations. So it's a real mixed...
Real vast. It could be students, teachers, professors in the education field, advertising agency folks. I mean, it really touches upon almost everything.
So tell us the website one more time.
Socialmediaassociation.com.
Socialmediaassociation.com. And so we're gonna talk about it in a little more detail right after we get back, but we're gonna talk about how nonprofits can stand out, maybe some resources that might be available to them. Mm-hmm. We're gonna talk about some of the things that the Social Media Association of Long Island does, mm-hmm. some of the programs you just mentioned. And we're also gonna talk a little bit about maybe some ways listeners can support nonprofits. Mm-hmm. All that? All right, so you heard it here, folks. This is Karen Signoracci, The Big Picture, 103.9. We've got a lot to cover. I have Nina McCann here from Social Media Association of Long Island, and we'll be back. Hello and welcome back. This is The Big Picture on 103.9 Long Island News Radio. I am your host, Karen Signoracci. And as I said before, I've spent most of my career raising money and building nonprofit boards and talking about community outreach. And I feel very strongly about the nonprofit community on Long Island and how much work that they do and how much service they provide and people they employ and areas that they need. And one of them we're going to talk about today is social media. So I have Nina McCann here. She is a board member of the Social Media Association of Long Island. Tell us the website again.
Yes, it is thesocialmediaassociation.com. I encourage folks to go and check it out. We actually just rebranded, relaunched it, so it's very nice now.
So you can see the mission of the association. Mm-hmm. You're all volunteers that are social media marketing professionals,
yes.
Maybe with a company, maybe with a nonprofit, maybe a sole practitioner or a business, and you come together to learn yourselves, to provide good content and details. What would be, Nina, one or two pieces of advice you would give specifically to nonprofits relating to social media?
I would encourage nonprofits to ask the corporations that they do business with to I'd have somebody ask them, like my page. That way the folks in charge of those companies, you know, kind of see through their social media channels what this nonprofit is doing. Maybe they only know of them from that one, you know, the annual golf outing, but they do so much during the year. They have galas, I'm sure. They have other fundraising efforts. So if the nonprofit encourages, you know, folks to like their page, they'll see, their overall, all their other activities that they're doing to raise awareness of their nonprofit and raise funds for them. They themselves should tag, the companies or folks that they are engaging with. Because once you tag them, you connect with their network and it becomes a situation where it's like, and so on and so on and so on. So, your reach is broader.
So, we're all still learning about social media in some ways. And like, we also can kid around like 20 years ago, this wasn't even a topic of conversation, and the jobs that are there now weren't even in place. And so we're all learning. And, I try to like, comment, and share.
Mm-hmm. Perfect.
And I'm saying that across all channels. So we're talking about LinkedIn, we're talking about Facebook, mm-hmm. we're talking about Instagram, and we're talking about Twitter.
Correct.
Those are the ones we're going to talk about for today. We're not going to go anywhere else with anything else. And like I said, we're all learning. So your advice for nonprofits would be to go to the companies that support them.
Mm-hmm.
And it could be companies, it could be organizations, mm-hmm. and say, hey, like our page.
Yes.
And so you can see what we're doing, not just related to the golf outing or the gala, but mm-hmm. you could see our ongoing work, our ongoing mission in action.
Correct, correct. Because they'll sometimes push out their annual report or articles. It just keeps them, it keeps the user or their contact engaged in the company more than the once-a-year touch.
Now, we also want to keep in mind that all of these different nonprofits and all these different areas have maybe a month
that they're recognizing. Mm-hmm. Like, for example, I know that May is Mental Health Awareness Month. Mm-hmm. Is there any other tip you have in relation to recognizing those months related to social media that a nonprofit could implore?
Beyond, there's so many amazing, you know, months to recognize.
Yes.
There's Women's History Month as
correct.
Well, and, you know, all the other diverse and inclusion type months. I just think that, you know, even when, you know, the months pass, it's really just always looking for content to push out. It's stay top of mind, mm-hmm. you know, beyond your events, beyond those, you know, months that are particular to your nonprofit. You know, we just had recently through Social Media Association, we're starting to engage actually with nonprofits every month. So we try to do different activities with them or for them. We recently did a walkathon with one of our nonprofits that we're engaging with. And again, you know, they're going to post about it. We're going to post about it. It's about sharing, you know, both of our missions and, you know, pushing it out to our communities.
So the Social Media Association of Long Island is meeting regularly? You meet every month?
We do. We meet every month via Zoom mainly. But we see each other more than that because we do try to have monthly educational or networking programs.
So if I understand this correctly, the association is having their own programs to learn about the industry, to maybe have a special topic, mm-hmm. a speaker,
mm-hmm. correct,
a program, educational in nature that members and non-members can attend?
Yes, they both can attend. Obviously, members don't, there's a special, they don't have to pay.
But, and students, you mentioned students before
students,
too.
Students, yes, we encourage students.
And then you're also finding partnerships with nonprofits as an association.
Yes.
And you did a walkathon.
Yep.
And so you're getting involved in the community.
Yes.
As an association.
As an association, because we feel that that's very important, you know, to, you know, beyond our world of, like you said, LinkedIn and Twitter and Facebook, you know, we want to engage with our community, you know.
So they know about your work and mission and that they have a group of people that... Another, it's like another burst of people that now know about them.
Correct.
So in how much time, if you don't mind my asking, have you been involved with the association yourself?
I've been a member for a couple of years, and I actually just recently joined the board last year.
You joined the board.
Yes.
So is there anything over the last few years that stands out, like where you had just a proud moment as an association where you're thinking to yourself, wow, it's clicking. We're getting somewhere.
Actually, the website rebrand was a great moment because we, you know, in looking back and updating and adding content to this new website, we just saw a lot of great programs that we have done throughout the years, you know, that were topical then, maybe outdated now. But, you know, it's an industry that's always evolving, you know, and growing. And that's why we're still learning as well. I mean, you know. That, like I said, we recently had something on ChatGPT. I mean, I didn't know about that last year.
I don't know what the details on. I know I've heard of it, but so the program was on ChatGPT. GPT and AI.
Yeah, because AI, right, artificial intelligence. Yeah, it's kind of a new wave or buzzwords. Yeah.
So what you're saying by putting the website together and like maybe relaunching it, and it's anyone that has worked on a website, it's like a labor of love.
Yes.
Because you're thinking, do I have archives? Do I have photos? Do I have enough? And people, how many people look on their computer or on their phone? It's probably more mobile.
Exactly.
So by doing the website, you were able to see, wow, we've done a lot.
We've come a long way.
And we provided good content. We've gotten involved in the community. Mm-hmm. We've grown our membership.
Yes.
And you're providing an educational opportunity. What have you learned in your collaborative work with colleagues that are also in the same arena with you and by being a part of the association? What have you learned and what have you taken from it?
Well, you know, everybody's story is so unique and everybody's path and everybody's background. And it's just, you know, like when we come together to put a program together, everybody has a different perspective because of all that. You know, it's very interesting. So I just keep learning from my board, you know.
And you work collaboratively. You work as a team.
We work as a team and we're a good team. Yeah,
that's great.
It's a good board.
That's great. Is there anything else that you think is really important for nonprofits to know in relation to social media, or anything that you think is important even for the Long Island community that you would want to share with us?
I would really encourage them, you know, to stay active and be visible and be present on your social media channels. Don't just put up a page and do nothing with it.
Right.
Please be active. It'll help build your community. It'll help grow your community. It's just, you know, one thing, you know, not to bring up COVID, but definitely, you know, when COVID happened, nobody was doing print advertising, you know, that kind of died. And then social media and digital, all that took off. So it's here to stay.
Let's do it. That's great. That's great advice. So be consistent, put stuff out there, tell your story. You know, we talk about that a lot on The Big Picture. Tell your story. So Nina, thank you for being here today. One last time, the website for the Social Media Association of Long Island.
Yes, it's thesocialmediaassociation.com. Thank you.
Thank you, Nina. Thank you for listening. Again, this is Karen Signoracci. This is The Big Picture on 103.9 Long Island News Radio.
The views and opinions expressed on this program are not necessarily those of this station, JVC Broadcasting Management, or its sponsors.